On behalf of the Hochstein School, welcome to our performance hall. Serving our community for more than 100 years, Hochstein celebrates all who enter here as supporters of the arts. We ask that you take notice of the emergency exits located at all corners of the hall on both levels. Restrooms are to the back of the hall, downstairs. Additional accessible bathrooms are located on the main level of the school building. Please take a moment to silence your electronic devices. For the courtesy of everyone in attendance and on stage, we ask that you remain seated and only enter and exit during applause or a break in the program. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
Welcome to our first concert of the year. My name is John Fetter. I'm the director of the Symphonia you see before you and the Philharmonia, which we'll be performing for you later. Along with myself and this group, we have Dr. Terry Smith, who helps us out a ton. And I want to say from the outset that we had a little error in the program. We had two Williams who played viola, and one of those Williams wasn't with us anymore, but accidentally both Williams got removed from the program. So I just want to acknowledge William Goodyear right here is very much a part of the viola section and very important to us. All right, so that is very important. I need to take care of that right away. We're going to play three pieces for you. One is by Václav Nelhýbel, a Czech composer. This piece is not a student piece. This is a real piece of music that has a lot of tricky stuff going on in it, and I want you to appreciate their hard work and their effort. You'll see furrowed brows and working and counting and helping each other and stand partners working together and all that kind of stuff. So. This piece has several different sections in it, and it ends with a bang. It really kind of ends with some energy. So we hope you enjoy Danza by Václav Nelhýbel. I just had to take a moment and silently celebrate. Will you please give him another round of applause? For his So the seating rotation you're seeing is something we do with both the HSS and with the HPO. I'm a violinist, and I have found it to be throughout my life and career as a violinist incredibly strange to sit in the front versus sitting in the back. It's a very, very different experience. Sitting in the back is 1,100 times more difficult. Sitting in the front is like being all warm and cozy, and it's nice, and there's all this sound around you. It's almost like being on the podium, which is really the best seat in the house, sorry. But sitting in the back is difficult and uncertain, and you have to be laser focused, and especially in a lovely room like this. This is a wonderful room for music, but it's actually very challenging for young musicians. We rehearse in this space once before the concert, well, twice effectively before the concert, but only for 2 days. We rehearsed yesterday in here, and it's very different than our rehearsal space over at Dupsey, which we love, and it works great for us, but then we come over here and it sounds very different, and they did an amazing job. Those of you who were here for our pickup rehearsal may have noticed that went really well. We're very pleased. Very, very pleased. Yeah. Some of them are definitely looking at me like, why are you giving it away? But it was really a wonderful performance, and we're going to keep going with our wonderful performance. We're going to play for you two movements of Prokofiev's classical symphony, his first symphony. Prokofiev is being featured by both of our ensembles today. You'll hear some Prokofiev later as well. I'm a big fan of this music. The classical symphony is a delightful piece. Prokofiev was not a classical era composer. He's a 20th century composer. But the music that he wrote, especially early in his career, honored a lot of the classical music ideas. But then he would take drastic key change turns and funny little things would happen in the music, and it's not what you would expect if you were listening to Mozart, but it kind of reminds you about, like, it kind of reminds you of Mozart a little bit. We're playing the last two movements of this, and the gavotte, this arrangement of the gavotte is very true to the original. It's the same length, it has the same sort of musical features in it. And then we'll play the finale from the movement, which is just the exposition of that, but is again very true to the original. So we hope you enjoy Prokofiev's gavotte and finale from the classical symphony.
Thank you. Talk amongst yourselves.
Thank you.
Well, hello again. Now you have before you our, here at Hochstein, we have four youth orchestras. We have the Hochstein Concertino Strings, we have, which has a concert on November 12th. Is that right, November 12th? Sorry? Okay, Sunday in November 12th. My daughter's playing it, I should know when it happens, but we'll figure it out. But that group is our first string orchestra. Then we have the Hochstein Sinfonia Strings, which you saw right over there. And I have one more. Push up. And then we have here the Hochstein Philharmonia Orchestra, and then our HYSO, our Hochstein Youth Symphony Orchestra. This is our first full orchestra. So you have in front of you a number of very actually experienced wind students who are playing winds and brass instruments with us. And some of them haven't played in an orchestra before. Some school programs don't have a full orchestra opportunity for them. So it's a really nice thing that we can offer as sort of a growth orchestra for them. But you can hear it. They don't sound like they're just a growth orchestra. They sound like the real deal. That was really fun. So many of the little things that make a difference between what a high-level professional orchestra sounds like and a young orchestra sounds like, there are very small, simple details. The way you phrase a note, the way you end a note, the way you approach the instrument before you start to play. And they really understand that. They're doing a great job making that happen. There are several adults, I'm not going to acknowledge them individually. They are in the program that are helping us out, that are joining us. On stage, and I'd just like to say thank you to all of them who help us out, Hochstein faculty members and friends and associates and people who are willing. It's a wonderful thing to have such a big musical community that you can draw on and work together on things. And I also want to thank Mr. Matt Osika, who's back there at the piano. He's the assistant director for this group, and Dr. Smith is sitting there playing oboe. She's the assistant director for the Symphonia, so you can tell we all work together a lot. and it's a lot of fun, and this is a great place to work and a great place to learn. And they do, students do a really fabulous job. The next piece we're going to play for you, I will admit, and I have said this much to them, is one of my favorite pieces of music. Prokofiev wrote a ballet about Romeo and Juliet, classic story, wrote a ballet about it, wrote the music for the ballet, and the ballet has several movements that were made into suites, two separate suites, and this is the opening movement from one of those suites. It depicts the two warring families, the Montagues and the Capulets, and then in the middle, we get a little, very innocent Juliet dancing, not knowing what's coming. So this is really from the beginning, the statement of these two families. So we hope you enjoy Montagues and the Capulets.
Thank you.
A wonderful story is that fabulous musicians take that wonderful story and very often offer their take on it. And so the last piece we're going to play for you is another take on ballet music for Romeo and Juliet. This is the Overture by Tchaikovsky. This is an arrangement, so there are a couple of cuts. There's some rapid chant transitions you won't be used to hearing if you know the piece well. But a lot of it's very true to the original. And it really gives us the opportunity to play this music with the real spirit that Tchaikovsky intended in this ballet music. Sometimes you'll hear this played along with Prokofiev and then maybe perhaps West Side Story or something like that. So there are a lot of ways that composers have treated this music, and it's really interesting to listen to the two different interpretations from two different composers, just the way that they treat this music. It does require a different kind of playing from the orchestra, and they've done a really fabulous job working on those aspects together and really making it fit. So our last piece for you is the overture from Tchaikovsky's Romeo and Juliet.
Oh.